Yo, it's your boy Zap.
And I'm Crystal.
And we're coming back at you with another episode of Zap Your Taste. Today's recipe is going to be over a one pot lemon pepper chicken and rice dish that you can find on Tasty.
You can see the link over here on top of his head somewhere if you're using your mobile phone, and if you're on the computer you can see it somewhere over here. And if you have any more questions about it, you can see another direct link in the description below.
So we'll just go ahead and jump into it. We're going to go ahead and eat it and tell you how we feel about it. Okay.
I dig it. The broccoli was not part of the recipe, but I believe in having a colorful plate and we needed something green.
Wow. Tasty might have something. We might have found something. This is really good.
Good.
Really good. The chicken has a good lemon pepper taste to it. I don't know if it was because there was a lot of seasoning on the piece of skin that I had, but just the chicken by itself has good flavor. Seems like it cooked into it. The rice has some good lemon pepper taste to it as well. I added a little bit more pepper to the dish because the recipe says you can to taste, and it gives it a nice little extra kick to it. You can taste everything. The rice is cooked well. The onions give it a nice little crisp bite to it. Good texture and everything. You can taste the lemon pepper, of course, because of all the seasoning that was in it, and because of the butter and the parmesan that you added to the end of the recipe, it gives it a nice little like risotto.
Yeah, like creamy.
Creaminess. The parmesan you can taste, the garlic, the butter gives it a nice little smooth flavor to it. Everything is great. How do you feel about it?
It's really good. I'm a pretty tough critic when it comes to these things, but I am satisfied and I can't wait to take some for lunch tomorrow.
Well, you have enough because
it's a lot.
So,
a lot of rice.
It's a lot of rice. The recipe says it will serve 4 people. And that's kind of true because there's
four pieces of
chicken and 2 pounds of chicken thighs. But then with the amount of rice that the recipe calls for, it definitely gives you more rice to chicken ratio. If you're like me, I eat a lot of rice. It's great. Crystal, on the other hand, not that big of a rice eater. Again, I eat a lot of rice. I'm Asian. Maybe that's it. But all in all,
it tastes really good.
It's really good.
I give it 5 lightning bolts.
5 lightning bolts. That's great.
Do you give it 5 lightning bolts?
I give it.
It's really good.
It's really good. I give it about 4.5 lightning bolts. It's a dish that I will keep in my back pocket to cook, you know, another day if we're just like, hey, what should we cook? One pot lemon pepper chicken and rice. Because again, everything in one pot makes it super easy. On the ease of cooking, or how easy it is to cook, I would say this would be 4, maybe 4.5 lightning bolts. For the simple reason of everything being in one pot. That is awesome. So I've seen a lot of the crock pot meals where everything goes in one big pot and then you just cook it. Same exact thing. This has a little bit more to do because you just don't leave it in there. You gotta actually cook, put the ingredients certain times and all of that. But all in all, I would give it about a 4 to 4.5 lightning bolts as far as ease of cooking. You helped cook.
I did.
What do you think?
I give it about the same, 4.5, 5. It was really helpful that he had everything already laid out and prepared. So we was just pouring, da 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 da. And it went by fairly quick. Baking time was the longest part. It just took 30 minutes to bake it, but once it was prepared, it was okay. So I'll give it a 4.5 lightning bolts.
And again, that adds to my reasoning of giving it about a 4 to 4.5 lightning bolts because of the time. Just like my last review of the shepherd's pie potato skins, you can click on a link right here if you want to go watch it. So cooking time is a big factor to me because we have a daughter that we have to take in consideration. You know, if she says, oh, well, I'm hungry, you don't have
an hour
to cook a meal. Parents out there, you know, if you have a kid and they're saying they're hungry, they want to eat or they'll get cranky. And you just don't want to deal with that. So the time frame again brings it down to about a 4, 4.5. Hey, all in all, good job tasting. The next time that you see us will be Friday. I will post another video of our behind the scenes of actually cooking it and everything. Be on the lookout for that. And in the meantime, continue to zap your taste.
I'm already done eating.